Hello everyone, Namaste. I am Munna Kahar, teacher of Joint School Family, and I am continuing your class 8 science subject. Okay, so we are continuing our lesson 4 pressure chapter. Okay, so today we have one new topic, that is your relative density. So what is the relative density? Okay, what is relative density? It is the ratio of density of a substance to the density of water. Okay. The ratio of density of a substance to the density of water is called relative density. Okay, simply relative density is your density of substance upon density of water. Okay, actually the density of water is considered as standard density. Okay, so we compare the density of a substance with the density of water. Okay, and we form a ratio here, density of substance upon density of water is called the relative density. Okay, so this term sometime asks in your exam. Okay, define relative density. So simply what you need to do is here, the ratio of density of a substance to the density of water is called relative density. Okay, and then sometime the question, one more question asks, why the relative density do not have unit? Okay, actually relative density is the ratio of a substance, okay, or the density of two densities. Okay, ratio of two densities, that is density of substance to the density of water. So the unit cancel here. Okay, so the relative density do not have any unit. Okay, so next topic is our floating and sinking. Okay, floating, I hope you know the term floating means mathi tairinu. Okay, and sinking means taller dubnu panima ya any liquid. Okay, so it depends upon the density of an object and the density of liquid in which it is placed. Okay, whether the object will float or it will sink, it depends upon the density of that substance, okay, and the density of liquid in which it is placed. Okay, so if the density of liquid is greater, okay, if the density of liquid is greater than the density of an object, then what happened? The object floats. Okay, if the density of liquid is more than the density of object, it floats. Okay, similarly, if the density of liquid is less, if the density of liquid is less than the density of an object, okay, then the object sinks. Okay, is it clear? Simply you need to remember this. And what happens sometime, we see that, okay, sheet made up of iron, okay, they float on the water surface. Actually the density of iron is greater than the density of water, but why do that sheet float on the water surface? Okay, because sheet, okay, displaces the water equal to its weight, its own weight. Okay, sheet displaces the water equal to its own weight and its base area is larger. Okay, so that is why your sheet, okay, float on the water surface as it displaces the water equal to its own weight. Okay, so I hope these two terms are clear here. Okay, so let's do some numerical from your exercise. Okay, simple example that we have already done in our previous class. Okay, so the explanation portion from this chapter is completed. Okay, so I will do only the numericals for you. Okay, please all of you concentrate. So from your page number 43, okay, so one question is there, question number D I am going to do for you. Okay, from your textbook, a tank contains a certain liquid in it. If the pressure exerted by the liquid is 7500 newton per square meter at the depth of 1.5 meter, calculate its density. And we need to take the value of g as 10 meter per square second. Okay, so our question is, a tank contains a certain liquid in it. Okay, if the pressure exerted by the liquid, is 7500 newton per square meter. Okay, at the depth of, depth means your height, okay, or you can say depth, 1.5 meter, this is your depth, we need to calculate the density of that liquid. Okay, so we have the formula. So what are the things given to us? For given thing, let's write here, given data is our, okay, pressure is given to us. Okay, what is the pressure given here? 7500, okay, 7500, okay, newton per square meter. Okay, and depth of liquid column, you can say, okay, depth of liquid column we take as h, that is a 1.5 meter. We need to calculate the density d. Okay, and g value may be given or may not be given to you. Actually, the actual value of g is a 9.8 meter per square second, but for convenient we take 10 meter per square second. Okay, so we have the formula for pressure is equal to h d g. Okay, so in pressure all are in SI units, so no need to change anything. 7500 is equal to h is your 1.5, d we need to calculate, and g is your 10. Okay, unit will write at last. Okay, so what will happen now? 1.5 and 10 is multiplying, so how much is here? Is equal to 1.5 into 10 is your 15 into d. Okay, so d is equal to now 15, transfer to left hand side. What it will do? It will just divide here. Okay, 7500 divided by 15. So what is the value we got here? That is your, it will exactly divide by 5. Okay, 500 kg per cubic meter. Okay, so your answer, density of that liquid is your 500 kg per cubic meter. Okay, simple, it is very simple. Pressure is given to us, okay, depth of liquid is given to us, 1.5. we need to calculate pressure is equal to SDG. We have the formula. Okay, in place of pressure we need to keep the pressure value. Height is your depth of liquid, that will act as, okay, height 1.5, and acceleration due to gravity, that is your 10. Actual is value is 9.8, but we are, for convenient we are taking 10. Okay, 10 meter per square second. Okay, so put the value, solve it, you will get the answer here. Okay, so I hope this numerical is clear for you. So now let's do another numerical. Okay, numericals are very easy, just you need to understand the terms there. Okay, your last numerical, okay, E number, your same page number 43, last numerical. A man with mass 40 kg stands with his one leg, okay, covering 20 square centimeter area. Okay, calculate the pressure exerted by his one leg on the ground. Okay, so here one man is standing on his one leg. Okay, only one leg he is standing. Okay, so this is the person here. Okay, but he is standing on his one leg only. Suppose he is standing on his one leg, and this area is given, one leg, the person is standing on his one leg, and the its area is given to us 20 square centimeter. Okay, figure is very comedian type, so I am erasing it. So okay, area of 1 foot is your 20 square centimeter. Okay, so area is given to us, that is a 20 square centimeter. So we need to convert into SI unit. Okay, so in SI unit, how can you convert? See here, okay, some of the students make a mistake here. It's very simple. Actually 20 square centimeter means 20 centimeter into centimeter, 1 centimeter, okay. So here it is your actually, okay, 20 into 1 centimeter into 1 centimeter, okay. Then you get centimeter into centimeter, square centimeter, one by one I am converting, okay. If you know directly, you can convert it directly, no problem, okay. But see here, okay. So 20 into this 1 centimeter, change it into meter, what it will happen? We will have to divide by 100, okay, because 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So to convert this centimeter into meter, we need to divide, okay. Similarly here also 1 upon 100, okay, now it will be converted into meter. So how much it is? So you can at last we'll do the cancellation, okay. Or 10 you can cancel here also, 10 cancel. So we got 2 into how much? 10 to the power 1 2 3 minus 3 square meter. So 10 into 100 is here, that is our 1000. We can write that 10 to the power, or as your choice, you can write here 2. Okay. How many zeros are here? 1, 2, 3. Okay. I'll show the full step. 1 upon 10 into how much? Power is 3 square meter. I will take this 2 in the numerator. So we got 10 into 10 to the power minus 3 square meter. Okay. I have just converted centimeters into meters, so area square centimeter is here, we are converting into SI system, that is your square meter. So we got 2 into 10 to the power minus 3, okay, square meter. So other what is given to us, mass is given to us, okay, mass is your 40 kg, okay. So we need to change it into weight, mass must be changed into weight, that is weight is also termed as force, okay. So weight, or you can say it as a force also, okay. Weight is equal to, or force is equal to mass into acceleration due to gravity, okay, is the formula. So mass is your 40 kg and acceleration due to gravity will take at 10 meter per square second, okay. So we will get here 400 newton, okay. So this is our weight, or you can take this as a force, okay. Mass should be converted into weight, or you can say that this is your force, okay. Force is equal to mass into acceleration due to gravity. So we have the mass, change it into force, okay, or the weight. So we have force and area we have. So we have the formula for pressure. Pressure is equal to force upon area, okay. What formula we have? Pressure is equal to force upon area. So pressure is a 400, okay, divided by 2 into 10 to the power 3 minus 3, okay. This much Pascal we will get here. Please solve it. This it will cancel 200, okay. 200 means your 2. This will go up 10 to the power 3, it will become, okay, Pascal. Or you can write 2 into 10 to the power 5 also, or 2 5 zeros also you can write, that is your choice. This I have taken to the numerator, okay. So I hope you can easily do. Or here also you can write 2 upon 1000 like that, okay, your choice. Anyway you solve it, this is your mathematical portion. I hope you can easily solve it, okay. So at last you will get your answer 200 into 10 to the power 3, or your choice 2 after 2 5 zeros you write, or your choice, okay. Here anyone you can write, that is your choice. This is a mathematical portion, you can solve it your way, okay. So I hope you all have understood, okay. So area is given here. Here the main thing is the person is standing on one leg, so we will take the area of one leg. If the person stands on two legs, we need to take the area of both the legs, okay. So please read the question carefully. Change it into square meter, okay. Mass is given in kg, change it into newton, okay. That is weight. Weight we call as force also. Change it and find the pressure, okay, exerted by one leg. So pressure exerted by one leg is at 210.3 Pascal, okay. So thank you for today, everyone. Please stay home, be safe. Thank you.